Hi fans, are you a Green Bay Packers fan? If yes, you are in the right channel. Before watching the video, I ask you to please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Thank you. With time on his side, Eric Stokes' rehab trending in a positive direction. The 24-year-old hasn't participated in team drills, but the Packers are encouraged by his rehab and Week 1 availability isn't out of the question. It'd be premature for the Green Bay Packers to consider third-year cornerback Eric Stokes to be a part of their lineup by the time they open the regular season. After all, the 24-year-old isn't just coming off of one significant injury, but two of them. He tore his meniscus and sustained a Lisfranc injury in a November 6 against the Detroit Lions at Ford Field. He was not only lost for the remainder of the season, but the team's young, blossoming defensive backs 2023 campaign was put in jeopardy as well. Stokes' injuries were the first of three decisive blows dealt to the Packers that afternoon. Pass rusher Rashawn Gary tore his anterior cruciate ligament, and wideout Romeo Doux sustained an ankle injury on the first offensive snap from scrimmage. Through the early portion of organized team activities, however, Stokes' rehab has been encouraging. He was cleared to run with the rest of the secondary in May, but the Packers are still erring on the side of caution with so much time still to go before they truly need him. "He's done a great job," said head coach Matt LaFleur on Wednesday. "I think he's made a lot of great strides in his rehab and he's been running around, so hopefully before the end of this, maybe he'll get in there for some individual. I don't foresee him in any team situations through the course of OTAs and into minicamp." LaFleur and company could be singing a different tune by the time training camp rolls around in late July, assuming Stokes' trajectory continues to trend upward. A first-round pick of the Packers in 2021, Stokes headlined a draft class that, at this moment, has proven to be less than stellar. Wide receiver Amari Rodgers, offensive lineman Cole Van Lanen, and tailback Kylan Hill are no longer with the team. Josh Myers appears to be the Packers' long-term plan at center, but the coaching staff has indicated that his job along with the two spots to his right are all up for grabs this summer. Offensive lineman Royce Newman, defensive lineman Tedarrell Slayton, cornerback Shemar Jean-Charles, and linebacker Isaiah McDuffie have all cemented themselves as backups until proven otherwise. But a thin, unproven defensive line could prompt an extensive role for Slayton this season. Stokes was a rising star in the Packers' secondary as a rookie, and his speed was an elite trait that helped him keep up with some of the league's top pass catchers. He ended his first season in the league with an interception, 9 pass breakups, and an allowed passer rating of 78.8. In his sophomore season, it appeared that he was experiencing something of a slump. In the 8 games prior to his injury, he didn't register a single pass breakup and allowed a passer rating of 125.8 when targeted. His coverage was tested 25 times and he surrendered 21 receptions, a completion rate of 84% for opposing quarterbacks. It's not a cause for concern given how young he is. There's room for error at this stage of his career. But how he rebounds from a pair of consequential injuries will be the deciding factor that determines the makeup of the Packers' secondary in 2023. As of right now, the team's intention is for Jair Alexander and Rasul Douglas to start on each boundary with Kayshawn Nixon as their nickelback. With the Packers yet to even take the field for mandatory minicamp, these plans are in a fluid state. Stokes' status, good or bad, will more than likely opt them to take a different avenue. It's possible Douglas flips inside with Alexander and Stokes on the perimeter. Douglas was the Packers' starting slot cornerback for the first half of the season last year. Stokes' injury, though, forced some shuffling. After playing 189 snaps inside through the Packers' first 8 games, Douglas played just 9 through the remainder of the season. Release the like on the video and subscribe to the channel. I update you with the news in the next video. Bye.